Hello, everybody. Welcome to Crafty Soup. My name is Misty. Today I have for you a layout process video as part of the design team for the Counterfeit Kit Challenge. And I will have links for everything down below. So if you don't know what I'm talking about, you can find more information. So here is my kit for the month of July. And I pulled out this piece of Paige Evans paper, which is a map print. And that's because our challenge is all about foreign languages and using terms or phrases as part of your page to tell a story. So I'm actually going to use no photos on this layout and just use the words, especially in foreign languages, to tell the story of how many different foreign language classes I tried to take, and none of them ever stuck, and I know very little of any foreign languages. So that has been my adventure with trying to learn foreign languages. So I wanted to create these spots that will hold the words in each of the languages. And I'm going to create these little pieces that go from that enamel dot on the map down to the spot. So those red pieces are going to lead the eye up to the various bits. Now, because those enamel dots were blending in a little bit, I just outlined them with a journal pen, and that is enough to give them more texture. So I wanted these little spots to stand up a little bit more, but I didn't want them to be quite as thick as foam dots. So I just stacked up a couple of layers of cardstock behind them. And that gives them just the right amount of dimension that I was looking for. So here I am gluing my red strips down to the paper. And because I wanted to try and conserve that striped paper, I didn't want to cut it all apart just to get the red strips. I am breaking it up into chunks and spreading it past those circles so that I have enough of that stripe paper left over for other projects. I did realize that I needed one more stripe after all because it couldn't reach all the way across the page, so I did have to cut out one more and piece that around. So now I have the main parts that are going to hold small pieces of my story, and it will get all tied together with my title. Now, I want to use those cut apart tag pieces, and I was looking for a color that would work, and because I'm going to use some more stripes under my title, I went for yellow. And that was just because it used up my leftovers the most efficiently, and so sometimes there's not big complicated reasons behind my color schemes. I was sticking with more of the kind of primary line there with green's not technically a primary, but we've got red, yellow, and blue, and then green fits in there. So sometimes you can just make do with what you've got and use that as another color if you're looking for more colors for your color scheme. All right, as I'm building up these little circles with my foreign language words on there, I did use those tags and piece them together. I would clip off the cornered ends of the tags and glue them together right in the middle. And for the most part, you can't necessarily see where those tags were glued together. Now, for this one in particular, I needed to use three tags to get it to be long enough to fit the word bonjour from French. So I just made do and pulled them all built them all up that way. Now I'm turning to my title, and this sticker sheet seems like it has enough alphabet letters on there to do me good for a title, and yet I had only half the letters I needed, so I did have to go and Frankenstein my letter pieces back together with other bits, and I made it work. So it says, third time's a charm, nope is the subtitle. So that's kind of my cheeky little way of saying that I was very bad at learning languages. So I did, throughout high school and college, I took German, I took French, and I took Spanish, and none of them ever stuck. Although I probably know more Spanish than any of the other ones because I did work the hardest on those. At any rate, I have moved on to some more of these little tag cut apart pieces, and I'm going to use those to kind of border my journaling. I'm going to create a little, it's not a mat exactly, it's just kind of these border pieces that are going to help outline and hold my journaling in place. And I definitely wanted to use that open space on the map for my journaling so that it would be easy to read and still give me plenty of room to say what I needed to say. So I'm going to create some little embellishment pieces out of some of this scratch paper. I did have a stamp set in my kit this month, and so I just pulled out my favorite black VersaFine ink, and I am creating these little tiny arrow embellishments to go with my journaling, and I am using that leftover paper from the title so that I can pull that yellow color across more parts of the layout. I always like to try and make sure I've got some repetition going on when I am designing my pages. All right, with my journaling borders in place, I am starting to cluster up a few embellishments around here. I had some various tags that parts of the tags worked for this layout with words and phrases that made sense. So I'm feeling happy to just cut them apart. I usually save the other pieces, but quite honestly, they often go unused in the end. But at least I used the tag for what I needed, and I can build up a little bit of embellishment cluster with all these bits and pieces. There were a couple of clouds in this kit in the kind of blue tone, so that worked to add a little bit to the top of my layout to help balance the heavy clusters around my journaling at the bottom. So that gives me a little more balance on the layout there. And I have this teeny tiny tag that I added another word to and got it on there, and that finishes my layout. So my question for you is, do you ever do layouts with no photos? I've been finding myself doing them more and more lately as I'm telling stories from my past and not necessarily having photos to go with those. So I use elements from the pattern papers and from my supplies to build up the visual elements of my story without having any photos. Let me know what you think. Thank you for joining me today. I do hope you got something useful out of this episode. I will be back on Wednesday with my free sketch files for you and a layout process to go along with that. I hope you'll join me then. I'll see you next time.